Okay, so here we have the rain. They had quite a bit of spraying yesterday. The sprays eventually clogged up the sky as you see it now, basically, last night. And then this morning the rain started. And you can see we have the characteristic somewhat windy condition here. The wind comes from the manipulation of the ionosphere, expanding the ionosphere and or contracting it according to the models they developed to produce rain. So the sprayed particulates are used to absorb the moisture and or sort of capture it. And then once the sprayed particulates have absorbed the moisture, then the HARP Gwen Towers cell tower manipulates the particulates in the air and or heats or cools a certain portion of the ionosphere to produce either high or low pressure zones. And that's how we have rain now in 2017. It didn't always used to be this way, but man has figured that he can control Mother Nature better than she can. So this is the situation we find ourselves in today. So it just quit raining. It's been sort of overcast like this, but you can see these clouds in the background. These are basically sprayed materials. They're in a line. They're sort of not natural, like you see these moisture clouds below it.
Sprayed materials,
most likely coal ash, aluminum, barium, strontium, sulfur.
It basically controls the moisture down below. And then actually here off in the distance we see
probably got a good 25 mile an hour per wind, 25 mile per hour wind. You can see the everything is moving pretty rapidly. It could be the same speed as the, and then we have the transmission tower right here. So those towers basically manipulate the sprayed materials. And so these are looking at clouds off the coast. The spray lines and the clouds off the coast. Okay, so this is the wind here. You can see it's moving the clouds in the background as well. And so basically they wouldn't want you to think about them controlling the weather, because if you knew what your adversary has planned, then you'd be prepared for it. And so basically they would not want you to know about this weather control stuff. And basically the way I see it is America has been sort of covertly taken over by the powers that be, the powers that manipulate the weather, the environment, the GMO foods, the radio frequencies in the cell towers, the radio frequencies, and Wi-Fi, cell phones, and as well the radio frequencies that basically, from what I understand, can pinpoint an individual from satellite and send certain brainwave frequencies to give them suggestions. And so most people are totally unaware of it, totally distracted by false flag events, wars. And that's my other thing. You know, I wanted to talk about this war thing. So basically, somebody's under the threat of war, some terrorist attack, then basically the government can do just about anything they want to, because it's like sort of under this War Powers Act, where they can do just about anything they want to, sidestep the Constitution. And so the way I see it, America has been basically covertly taken over. Covertly taken over. They wouldn't want you to think, they wouldn't want you to imagine the power that they have over you. And so a lot of times we'll be labeled as conspiracy theorists, and as well, you may have heard, Harvard has now come out promoting the idea of chemtrails to slow global warming, to reflect the sun back out in space. So in Harvard, this is the recent Harvard coming out, where Harvard has sort of recommended that this happen, although it's been happening. I've been documenting it probably for the last 4 years. A friend of mine up here has watched it happening for the last 8 years, it's probably 10 years now. But yeah, and so, yeah. Heads up, America. And so once again, we see the large tower here and the liney clouds. Now, if we look off the coast here, we see off the coast lines. These are basically lines. They're not billowy moisture clouds. Like, there are some moisture clouds there, but the lines behind it are the straight sprayed lines. These are sprayed material, micro dust, nanoparticulates of barium, sulfur, aluminum, strontium, and coal ash. And the mixture does change according to the weather, just like the fuel does as well. The gasoline changes from season to season. Anyway, once again, we see the lininess here to these, and we see the difference between the lines and the moisture clouds. The moisture clouds are basically normally below the lines, the sprayed lines. The sprayed lines contain or have the ability to move the moisture, disperse it, condense it, etc. And with the Gwin Towers or microwave HARP technology, they're able to create higher and low pressure zones in the ionosphere to push or pull the winds. And so basically, they basically are controlling the jet stream as well as the moisture in the air. I coined the term remote control cloud. So basically what they're doing is, through these towers, they have the ability to control these clouds. Remote control clouds. And so, yeah, it's just stopped raining about an hour ago. We have the clearing and we see the moisture clouds alongside of these sprayed materials. So, and I'm just a layman. I've just been studying this for about 3 years. I'm not a scientist. If I were, I'd probably be kicked out of the scientific union, because most people in places of power don't want to rock the boat. They want to keep their pension, their retirement, and so they're not going to rock the boat until they get their pension or whatever's been promised to them by those who print the money. The illusionary candle or carrot in front of the donkey kind of thing. And that's my report from Northern California. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.